The Japan Self-Defense Forces have officially unveiled the turret-mounted electromagnetic railgun, which is now installed aboard the test vessel JS Asuka. Since the mid-2010s, Japan's Ministry of Defense, through its Acquisition, Technology and Logistics Agency, ATLA, has been actively developing railgun technology, with the aim of eventually deploying these systems on both naval vessels and land-based platforms. Notably, this comes at a time when the U.S. Navy has stepped back from similar efforts, having discontinued its own railgun development in the early 2020s due to persistent technical hurdles. In this video, Defense Updates reports on Japan's railgun. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. JS Asuka AS-E6102 is a 6,200-ton experimental ship of the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force, which was commissioned on 22 March 1995. Earlier this month, ship spotters in Japan began sharing images of the new addition to JS Asuka. The Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force, JMSDF, has since released official photos as well. According to a brief statement from the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force, on 9th April, Vice Admiral Omachi Katsushi, Commander of Self-Defense Fleet, visited JS Asuka, which belongs to the Fleet Research and Development Command under the command of the Self-Defense Fleet, to observe the latest status of a railgun, which is under development at the Acquisition, Technology and Logistics Agency, ATLA. In preparation for future combat, the Self-Defense Fleet promotes research, development, and earlier introduction of equipment necessary for the JMSDF in close collaboration with the ATLA and other organizations, as well as continues to build up its defense posture to protect Japanese citizens and the territorial waters. Railguns are electromagnetic devices designed to launch projectiles at hypersonic velocities, relying on electromagnets rather than chemical propellants to fire their projectiles at very high velocities. The railgun's operation hinges on electromagnetic principles, specifically the Lorentz force, which arises when a current-carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field. The key components include rails, armature, and power supply. The two parallel conductive rails, usually made of copper, act as the barrel. These rails are connected at the breech, rear, to the power supply and extend to the muzzle, front, where the projectile exits. Armature is the conductive component, such as a solid metal slug, sabot, or plasma, that completes the electrical circuit between the rails. The projectile is often integrated into or carried by the armature. Power supply is designed to supply enormous electrical energy. It often uses capacitors or pulse generators, capable of supplying currents in the millions of amperes for milliseconds. Magnetic field strengths typically reach approximately 10 Tesla. The current generates a magnetic field around the rails, perpendicular to the current flow, as per Ampere's law. This force accelerates the armature and projectile along the rails toward the muzzle, achieving velocities around 2,000 to 3,500 meters per second, Mach 6 to 10. The shells are not full of explosives, but do damage by transferring kinetic energy. It is believed that an optimized railgun could hit targets 100 miles or 160 kilometers away due to flat trajectories and high velocities. To give viewers a perspective, the 5-inch Mark 45 Mod 4 gun installed on the U.S. Navy Arleigh Burke-class destroyer has a range of 23 miles or 37 kilometers. In 2023, ATLA announced it had successfully conducted live-fire tests of a prototype railgun at sea from an undisclosed platform, a milestone the agency claimed was a world first. At the time, images released by ATLA showed the railgun mounted on a test rig rather than the fully integrated naval turret now seen aboard JS Asuka. It's unclear how the railgun's design may have evolved since those tests, but the version currently installed on JS Asuka features design elements consistent with earlier prototypes previously revealed by ATLA. In earlier trials, the agency reportedly demonstrated the weapon's ability to fire projectiles at speeds of approximately Mach 6.5, using 5 megajoules of energy per shot. The stated performance goals have included achieving a muzzle velocity of at least Mach 5.8 and a barrel life of up to 120 rounds. ATLA's stated performance goals have included achieving a muzzle velocity of at least Mach 5.8 and a barrel life of up to 120 rounds. According to Naval News, the agency has also been working to reduce the railgun's onboard power requirements, a critical factor for potential deployment aboard future platforms. Railgun systems impose exceptionally high power and cooling demands, especially if a rapid fire rate is desired, and their repeated use at extreme velocities accelerates barrel wear, which degrades range, accuracy, and safety. Moreover, the large energy storage batteries and heat management hardware make them bulky. On JS Asuka, the railgun sits on the aft flight deck where open space is available, whereas mounting one in a conventional turret would require significant internal rearrangement. While not verified, the latest variant is a bit smaller than its previous two iterations, so Japanese scientists have been able to reduce its size. The JMSDF states that the railgun's velocity, energy, and range are adjustable, and its smaller projectiles are more difficult to detect or intercept. Officials highlight its potential to counter air, sea, and land threats with high speed and precision, while also lowering the logistical demands compared to traditional munitions. Japan's roadmap for fielding railguns remains fluid, but the full naval turret on JS Asuka signals a move toward operational deployment. At the UK's Combined Naval Event 2024, JMSDF Vice Admiral Imayoshi Shinichi, ATLA's head of naval systems, announced plans to fit the 13 DDX destroyers entering service in the 2030s with railguns, and ATLA has even published concept art depicting a Maya-class 27 DDG destroyer armed with this weapon. A fully operational electromagnetic railgun would provide a versatile, high-performance weapon capable of rapidly engaging targets at sea, on land, and in the air over substantial distances. Its relatively small, inexpensive projectiles promise far greater magazine depth and correspondingly lower per-shot costs than conventional shell, as well as surface-to-air or surface-to-surface missiles. This capability is especially valuable on warships, where deck space is scarce and at-sea missile resupply is logistically challenging. A railgun's ability to launch large volumes of low-cost rounds against diverse threats would be a significant tactical advantage. Japan's railgun program is part of a broader push to bolster and modernize its self-defense forces, alongside initiatives like new hypersonic missile development in response to mounting security pressures from North Korea, China, and Russia. In 2024, ATLA confirmed talks with the U.S. Navy to build on America's earlier research, and Japanese officials also signed cooperation agreements that year with France and Germany to advance railgun development. From 2005 until 2022, the U.S. Navy pursued a similar program, only to suspend it after encountering persistent technical hurdles and repeated delays in sea trials. It will be interesting to see if the two countries collaborate on this technology.